This is not a drill. We've all heard the warnings, but for too long now, the critical issues have fallen by the wayside.
You all come to us young people for hope. How dare you?
It's clear that we have had a tremendous amount of benefit, but we've left a lot of people behind.
The world has been coming to terms with the risks of unfettered capitalism, the realities of climate change, and vast societal shifts that have left so many behind.
We have homelessness at staggering rates, one of the highest rates of youth suicide in the OECD.
And in that struggle, wasted time has allowed trust to erode.
The greatest danger is the destruction of trust in presidents, in prime ministers, in political parties, in democracy itself.
We need to seize the opportunity to address the systemic flaws and make the future work for us all. In the 50 years since Klaus Schwab convened the first meeting, the world has changed dramatically.
If capitalism's going to sustain itself, it's going to provide secure jobs. It has to distribute wealth evenly, and it has to make a contribution to the common good.
That's why this year's forum sees the launch of a new Davos Manifesto, and it's a powerful opportunity to change business as usual.
We need a system that is based around core capabilities for absolutely everybody in this century to flourish and take part.
While the Western liberal economic order has reaped huge benefits, it's been too narrowly focused on the interests of shareholders. That's why the forum is pushing for stakeholder capitalism, a model where corporations are oriented to benefit not just shareholders, but all stakeholders. Customers, suppliers, employees, local communities. And this isn't just some fantasy idea that only benefits consumers. It's got major buy-in from serious economists, the big four accounting firms, and the banking sector.
Innovation historically has been the result of a collective effort. This idea that you're maximizing shareholder value and not stakeholder value didn't actually help us get, you know, the nanotech, the biotech, the internet revolution.
Health, well-being, education, gender equality, reduced inequality. We need to improve and build a better world for the future.
Many of the people who are changing the world are young people. The disruptors are going to be the people that change the world.
With half of the population below 27 years old, we have to listen to the young people and stuff what we will do.
Because we're all in this together. So help us build a fairer world.
As kids, what can we do right now?
Each and every one of us can make a difference. And each and every one of us on this planet, we do make an impact every single day.
Click the link. Use the hashtag, record a video, and have your say. Make your voice heard at the World Economic Forum.